Last week, pinirmahan ni President Duterte yung Republic Act 11594. And ito ay amending Article 183 of the revised Penal Code. Ito yung penalty for perjury, pagsisinungaling, no? Sabi nga nila, it's a sin to tell a lie, no? At under Article 183 of the revised Penal Code, the current minimum penalty for perjury is 4 months and 1 day to 6 months in prison, and the maximum penalty is 6 months and 1 day to 2 years and 4 months in prison. Dito sa ating bagong batas, ang penalty ngayon ay prison mayor in its minimum and period, and prison mayor to medium period. Ito ay minimum of 6 years and 1 day to 8 years in prison, and a maximum of 8 years and 1 day to 10 years. So, delikado na ang magsinungaling sa korte, sa senado, sa kongreso, or even sa isang government body, quasi-judicial body, and charge for perjury because napakataas na ng kanyang penalty. Pag ikaw ay government employee at you gave a false statement under oath at ikaw ay na-charge ng perjury, aside from the imprisonment, meron ka pang disqualification to hold public or appointed or elective position in government. And this is forever, no? At yung mga gumagamit ng false testimony ay meron ding penalty sa paggamit ng false testimony. So ano yung coverage ng bagong batas na ito? Article 180 ay false testimony against a defendant. Article 181, false testimony in favor of a defendant. Article 183, false testimony in other cases and perjury in solemn affirmation. And Article 184, offering false testimony in evidence. So, classic example, nag-affidavit ka, nag-sabi ka ng kwento doon. Later on, it was proven na hindi totoo yan, and na-charge ka sa court. Yan ang mag-a-apply sa iyo under the new law signed by the President.